Let's now talk to one of the former senator's lawyers, Attorney Dino De Leon. Attorney De Leon, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron, and to all our viewers.
Hi, sir. Even if she was acquitted, is this the last we'd hear of this case? Can prosecutors still appeal the ruling, or have you heard of any planned appeal?
It will be very unlikely because this is a criminal case, and in criminal cases, the prosecution cannot appeal an acquittal. That will go against the constitutional prescription against double jeopardy. The only exception to that if there's grave abuse of discretion. And in this particular instance, as the judgment would show, there is no grave abuse of discretion. The judge specifically cited his basis for acquitting the case. And that is, there is clearly reasonable doubt in light of the recantation of the prosecution's star witness. So while in exceptional cases, a petition for certiorari may be used to question the judgment, it is unlikely in this particular instance, we believe so, in the defense.
Okay, thank you very much for that explanation. We have Justice Secretary Boying Rimulya in his reaction to the court's decision saying that the ruling shows the rule of law has prevailed. 6 years and counting in detention. Do you or the former senator agree with the statements of Secretary Rimulya?
Well, ultimately, Senator Larry De Lima is happy that her acquittal finally came into fruition, considering the fact that the truth is on her side and she has been innocent. And we've always consistently stated that right from the day one. It is clear that all these charges are pure fabrications. This is the largest frame-up in Philippine history. And if Secretary Rimulya says that, you know, justice prevails, then we are glad that that happened. But it's sad that it took a while because Senator Larry De Lima was not able to fully fulfill her mandate as a senator for the last 6 years. And the reason why the Duterte administration weaponized the rule of the law against Senator Larry De Lima is precisely because they wanted to gag her into submission. So while the conditions have probably improved considering this next acquittal, it does not cancel out the fact that the previous administration trifled with the rule of law, trifled with the justice system, and they have to be held into account. So for the justice system to truly work, then this administration must likewise actually investigate those people who are involved in the largest frame up in history, which is the frame up of Senator Lenin.
Right. And how are you going to move forward on that?
Well, definitely, as Senator Lenin De Lima always says, there will always be a day of reckoning. The Lord's justice, as we say, may seem slow, but it grinds exceedingly fine. And there will always be a day of reckoning. And justice comes in numerous forms. But definitely within our justice system, the remedies we will avail of that for those particular remedies. As we see, the persecutors of Senator Larry De Lima are now under investigation, even in the international community. So what we are certain of is that we will continue fighting these trump up cases. And eventually, Senator Larry De Lima will exercise the remedies available.
If I remember correctly, Attorney, the former senator did file a complaint against the former Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre for allegedly false statements and masterminding the false statements that that were used against Laila De Lima. Whatever happened to that?
These cases are still ongoing with the ombudsman. So we look forward to the day when these people who are behind the persecution of Senator Larry De Lima will be held.
Still ongoing? When was that filed?
That was filed last year after incantation of Bertalan.
Okay. All focus now going into the last case. First, what's the word on the when the ruling on the bail petition will be coming out?
Well, we should have expected it anytime soon. Mm. In fact, we thought that it's going to come out last week. But unfortunately, there were problems when it comes to the markings of the prosecution. So that has been all sorted out at this point in time. And we hope and pray that anytime soon the bail resolution will come out. Senator Larry De Lima is not a threat to the society. There is no risk of her fleeing, and she has faced all these cases head on. So it is important that she be given provisional liberty consistent with jurisprudence and the guidelines set out by the Supreme Court when it comes to granting petitions for bail.
But pending the bail petition, what's the status of the whole case? Where is it now?
The prosecution has already rested its case when it comes to the bail proceedings. Thereafter, once the judge resolves the bail proceedings, they will still be given, I think they've been given around three settings for them to further present evidence with respect to the entire case. And thereafter, the judge will assess, of course, the case, and there will be remedies available to us after they formally offer their evidence or the entire case, which is possibly, let's say, for example, file for a demurrer to evidence. Because like the two other cases, we believe that this case also does not implicate whatsoever Senator Daya de Lima, and all of the allegations and accusations against her are, if not fabricated, are clearly inconsistent with each other.
Okay. Finally, Attorney De Leon, is the Lima camp feeling good about another acquittal and a completion of her vindication on the last case?
Well, we're hoping for the best, as Senator Daya de Lima said a while ago when some members of the media were trying to interview her. She said that, "May I say this to my oppressors, you can never crucify the truth. You cannot permanently stall justice." But of course, she also released a dispatch a while ago, and if I may just read it.
Go ahead.
She said, "I never wavered in my deep faith in our all-knowing, all-powerful, merciful, and loving God. I also never wavered in my firm conviction on the power of truth and justice. God is truly great. Humihingi pa rin po ako ng patuloy na panalangin para naman po doon sa isang kaso." You know, we always say in the defense team, this has been a recurring theme for the last 6 years. We always say that the arc of the moral universe may be slow, but it bends towards justice. We want to say, and as Obama said, it doesn't bend on its own. So we hope that the public will continue to actually monitor the case so that we can all fight for justice together.
Attorney Dino De Leon, lawyer for former Senator Laila de Lima, thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Ron, and good afternoon to all of you.